Hello friends, my today's topic is types of quadrilateral by paper folding activity. Properties already I have explained you. If time permits today, I will explain properties once again. So we require few things, few rectangular papers, few means 6 or 7 rectangular sheets, small paper, scale, scissors, pen, pencil, a few colorful sketch pens and Fevicol. Okay, so let us start. The first one is parallelogram. How to make a parallelogram with the rectangular sheet? So आपको एक rectangular sheet लेना है. आप इसे बीच से fold कर दीजिए. इन videos में इन चीजों में crease बनाना बहुत important होता है, तो आपको एक crease बनाना है. Once again you open it, take the scale and join these two points, this vertex and this middle point, and just fold it, make a crease once again. Okay, same way, now this end point and this vertex and middle point, again just keep the scale and fold it. Okay, just open it and you will get one parallelogram. Students and teachers, here you can use one side used sheets also, so that we can save paper also. So this is the way we got one parallelogram. Okay, keep this parallelogram aside. Now second one, always we after parallelogram we go for rectangle. So already we have one rectangular sheet, no need to do anything. Now next one, always we go for square. How to make a square? Just fold it. Square also everybody knows that whatever extra is there, fold it and open it again. So this way you will get one square. Even I am also using here one side used sheets because I don't want to waste pages. Okay, now next one is a rhombus. How to make rhombus? Just take rectangular sheet, fold it, make a crease. Once again you fold it, so you will get this paper. Okay, this rectangular sheet is in 4 fold. Open it. Yeah, so you can see that these 4 midpoints, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So one by one we will join this midpoint, these 2 midpoints, and make a crease over here. Now take these 2 midpoints, make a crease once again. Again now take the middle one, lower one, these 2 middle points, make a crease, and similarly take the last 2 middle points and make a crease. Okay, now after that, wherever crease is there, fold it. Since I am using the used one sheet, that's what I am folding in the opposite side. If you are using the fresh sheet, so already you are getting the crease, you can fold along the crease. So now you can see that this is the rhombus. Okay, now next is trapezium. So for trapezium, again you fold it. Okay, this I have folded in 2 parts. Now this point and any this vertex and any point wherever you want, you can fold this, make a crease, remove your scale and again fold it. So you will get trapezium. So this is your trapezium. This is isosceles trapezium because we have taken these 2 sides equal. Okay, if you want to make any other simple trapezium that is not isosceles, so any way you can fold, this is your choice. You can fold this one little bit smaller and here you can fold little bit bigger. Okay, you need to take this vertex, the last one, that is very important. just fold it. So this is your trapezium. This is trapezium. This is isosceles trapezium. And the last one is left, that is kite. So again fold it. It's better fold it in vertical way. Okay. So this paper is in two fold. And make a small fold now. Don't make just half. Okay. So this way we have folded. Open it. Again use your scale and join these two points, this corner and this corner, with the fold we have got it, and just fold it, make a crease. Similarly, these two points, make a crease. Okay, same way upside also. And these two points also, just join the midpoints and make a crease. Remove your scale and just fold it. The crease you got, make it properly. If your lower one, any paper is extra, once again you can fold it, no problem. So this is the way you are getting kite. In kite you can see that I am getting some extra place. So just fold it once again at the back. So this is the way we got your kite. Okay. So with paper folding activity, I have shown you with this rectangular sheet. Okay. This rectangular sheet, by paper folding we can make parallelogram. This is rectangle, square, this is rhombus, this is isosceles trapezium, this is trapezium, and this one is your kite. For students, you can make this small paper folding activity, this types of trapezium, and you can stick in your notebook. Okay. Now I'll come for the teachers. After doing this, you need to use your sketch pen. Even students, you can use your sketch pen. I have made a bigger one so that I can explain the properties. Now this is the parallelogram. I have told you how to make. Now use your sketch pen to make the diagonals. Use your sketch pen to make the same sign, because in parallelogram opposite sides are equal and parallel. Opposite sides are equal and parallel. You can see here with diagonal, just fold it along the green color one. Once again you fold it along the green color one. So you can see that these two are equal. What does it mean? This green color diagonal bisect with this point. Similarly, you can show for this red color also. Fold it along with the red color diagonal. Okay. Once again you fold it. So again you can see that these two red color lines are equal. So we can say that this red color also bisect with this point. So we can say that diagonals bisect each other in a parallelogram. In parallelogram we can show that opposite angles are equal. For this you need to cut this and just overlap this. So these two angles will be same. Or if you will fold it little bit, it's tricky to fold. So you will get like that after cutting. So you can say that these two angles are equal. So we can say that in parallelogram opposite angles are equal. Okay. Now come for the rectangle. This is your rectangle. Again join the diagonals. Again here you can see that this green color diagonal bisect each other with this point. Similarly with rectangle also, you can see that this rectangle, once again folded. So again you can see that two equal length. Same way we can show that this green and red color length is also equal. This red and green color length is also equal. If you will make this, all the four parts of the diagonals are equal. Okay, what does it mean? The length of the diagonals are equal in a rectangle. All the four corners are 90 degrees. So each angle of a rectangle is 90 degrees. Opposite sides are equal in length. And what about the opposite angles? Here also opposite angles are equal. This is also 90 degrees. This is also 90 degrees. These two are also 90 degrees. Now come for the square. Again, square, you can draw here diagonals with two different color. Just fold it with the green color. So you can say that this is same. One more thing, if you will see here, this is your right angle. So this diagonals bisect at 90 degrees. Similarly, you can fold for the green color, red color. So again, you can see that this is 90 degrees. The same way, we can show that this red and green color part is same. Similarly, this also red and green color part is same. And once again, you will fold it. All the four parts of a diagonal is same. So this way, we can say that diagonals of a square are equal in length. Diagonals bisect at 90 degrees. These two are 90 degrees. These two are 90 degrees. So diagonals. Each angle of a square is 90 degrees. One thing is there. If you will fold this green color, you can see that these two angles are equal, this and this, because this overlap each other. These two angles are equal, these two angles are equal. Similarly, with the red diagonal also, you can see that these two angles are equal, these two angles are equal. So one more point, we can say that diagonals in a square bisect the angle. This diagonal bisect the angle. It means this is 45 and this is 45. This is also 45. This is also 45. Now this is rhombus. Again join the diagonals. Fold for the green color. And once again you fold it for the green color. So you can see that this green color two lines are equal. And at the same time you can see here 90 degrees. Okay. One more thing, this angle and this angle is same, this angle and this angle is same. Now same thing we will do with the red color. Fold it along the red color one. Once again fold it along the red color one. These two red color length is same. Here you can see that 90 degree angle. This angle and this angle is same. This angle and this angle is same. So we can say that diagonals of a rhombus bisect at 90 degree. Diagonals bisect the angles. Okay. Opposite sides are equal and parallel, or we can say that all the four sides are equal in a rhombus. Opposite angles are also equal. If you will fold this, you can see that these opposite angles are equal. Fold it again, you can see that opposite angles are equal. So opposite angles of a rhombus is also equal. Now next one is this isosceles trapezium. Again draw the diagonals. This is one diagonal, this is another diagonal. Okay, you can see that this small green and red color length is equal. Same way we can say that this bigger red color and green color, this length is also same. So if we will add this green with green, red with red, so you can find out the diagonals are equal in isosceles trapezium. And opposite sides which are not parallel, they are also equal. That's why this is called isosceles trapezium. Okay. And only one property is there for a trapezium, one pair of sides is parallel. Next one is kite. Kite, here you can see that if you will fold along the red color diagonal, so these two sides are equal. These two longer sides are equal. So we can say that in a kite, two adjacent sides are equal in length. Adjacent means nearby sides. Till now everywhere we were seeing that opposite sides are equal in length, but in kite adjacent sides are equal in length. Okay, if you fold it again with the green color, so you can see that here 90 degree. So we can say that diagonals intersect at 90 degree. Why I am not saying bisect? Because red color diagonal doesn't bisect. One is smaller, one is bigger. So diagonals intersect at 90 degree. And this green color, okay, this length and this length is same, and here this one is same. So longer diagonal bisect the angle. You can see that this longer diagonal bisect the angle, but green color, this shorter diagonal doesn't bisect. You can see that the angles are not overlapping. So this is the way we can explain all the properties of a parallelogram using paper folding activity. Same thing we can explain, the properties we can explain by GeoGebra also. In my next video, I will explain properties by using GeoGebra. So don't forget to watch that video. Thank you for watching today's video.